So this is the seventh video in our series of lessons on solving quadratic equations. Sorry, seventh video in our series of lessons on quadratics, and this one focuses on solving quadratic equations using the quadratic formula. So by the end of this video, you will be introduced to the quadratic formula and you will know how to solve problems involving the quadratic formula. Okay, so we're just going to briefly go into some examples and then I will let you know exactly what I'm talking about. So some quadratics, ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, cannot be factorised. And this is because they don't have any roots at an exact value. Okay, what we use to solve these quadratics, such as x squared plus 5x minus 3 equals 0, is the quadratic formula x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Now, I know this formula looks complicated and it looks like it would be difficult to memorise. You don't need to memorise it. It is on your formula sheet. But it is, in fact, incredibly easy to use. I'm going to do a comparison between my equation and the equation that the general equation that you're given at the top here. And you can quite clearly see for my x squared, my a value is 1. Well, I'm going to write that, so a is 1. For my b value, my b is 5. And my c value is negative 3. Now these three values are what get substituted into my equation, so I get negative 5 plus or minus the square root of 5 squared minus 4 times 1 times negative 3. All divided by 2 times 1. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is, at the same time as I simplify this, I'm going to separate it. So I'm going to get negative 5 plus the square root of 37 over 2. But my other solution, because I get two roots, is negative 5 minus the square root of 37 all over 2. And by putting both of these in the calculator and then working them out, I get that this one is 0.54 and this one here is negative 5.54. Okay, so two decimal solutions that you would never have got by factorising, but they are the roots of that quadratic, and that is why quadratic formula is necessary. If you want a proof for quadratic formula, then you can Google, and there are plenty of places out there that will prove it, but at this point all you need to do is just know the quadratic formula. Okay, so moving on to our next example. We've got x squared minus 3x minus 9, so I'm going to say that my a value is 1, my b value is negative 3, and my c value is negative 9. My quadratic formula is x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all divided by 2a. Substituting in my values, I want negative b. Well, b is already negative, so then b is going to be positive. So 3 or minus the square root of negative 3 all squared minus 4 times 1 times negative 9. All divided by 2 times 1. Okay, so separating and simplifying at the same time, I will get 3 plus root 45 over 2, or 3 minus root 45 over 2. And simplifying these, I will get the solution 4.85, or the second solution 1.85. Sorry, that's the solution negative 1.85. So two solutions, again, two roots you can graph and you can check, but again, you would never have got these by factorising. Okay, and one final example. We've got 3x squared plus 7x plus 1. So what we're getting here is an a value not equal to 1. But that doesn't change in the slightest. What we do We need to state our A, B, and C values, and we need our quadratic formula. So negative b plus or minus b square root of b squared minus 4ac all divided by 2a. Let's substitute in our values. So negative 7 plus or minus the square root of 7 squared minus 4 times 3 times 1 all divided by 2 times 3. So simplifying and separating at the same time, I get negative 7 plus the square root of 37 over 6, or I get negative 7 minus the square root of 37 over 6. And this time, we're wanting a solution to one decimal place. If I put this in the calculator, I get negative 0.2, or for my second solution, I get negative 2.2. And again, two solutions that you would not have been able to get without factorising that do in fact exist. And that is the quadratic formula. So let's go back and just compare and make sure that we've covered everything in this lesson. So by the end of this video, you'll have been introduced to the quadratic formula. Well, you definitely have. And you'll know how to solve problems involving the quadratic formula. Again, there you have it. Substituting into quadratic formula, simplifying and evaluating. Nothing too complicated or complex.